Well, it was the hit TV show with strong female characters that we loved and loved to hate. Prisoner turned the laundry press into a weapon and had us all cheering for the underdog. And in just a few months, it's 40 years since Prisoner hit screens on 10 and made TV history with scenes like this.
Now you listen to me.
Listen to you. You've got the brains of...
Just keep away from me! I never asked to be part of your stupid suburban bloody reactionary...
Oh, battling Sigrid Thornton there was TV legend Val Lehman, who played B on the show, and we are thrilled to have Val joining us from Brisbane this morning. Yay! Nice to see you. Now, a bee was one tough cookie. What was it like to play her?
Oh, look, who wouldn't want to play an actress like that? What actress wouldn't want to play a part like that? I mean, she was totally invincible and never wrong.
A bit like myself.
You shared the screen with so many other Aussie stars. We saw Sigrid there. There was also, of course, Colette Mann, Maggie Kirkpatrick, singer Jane Clifton. Did you guys have fun when the cameras weren't rolling?
We did, actually. Friday afternoons used to be difficult. We had very, very long schedules, you know. We were contracted for 12 hours a day and generally worked 15. So Friday, we used to get a bit tired, and so we used to get giggly. And a scene with Jane Clifton and Colette Mann and Betty Bobbitt and Sheila Florence and me was disastrous because we just couldn't stop laughing.
Now, the show was a phenomenon, Val, as you know, around the world, the UK especially, and you even got a letter from a prisoner from Alcatraz.
Not only did I get a letter from... I actually got regular letters from a prisoner from Alcatraz. Oh. But at the 30th anniversary, a prisoner from Alcatraz, an ex-prisoner from Alcatraz, turned up with a framed letter thanking me and all of the women in prisoner for changing the attitude to people in prison in general.
Wow.
I mean, because you're such a trailblazing show, long before Orange is the New Black, long before Wentworth. Oh, I mean,
way before.
Yeah, you had this incredible show and wonderful storylines on the air. You know, what do you think kind of cemented Prisoner in the history of television? What was
I
it
think
about
it brought
the show?
Out the voyeur in people, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, women in prison. Let's have a look at that.
Well, yeah.
Certainly got but me then, watching.
Absolutely.
But then once they did watch it, they realised that it was also full of characters that they could really relate to. Mm.
And
very
it was,
real people.
Yeah. It was all of these great roles for women.
Fantastic, yeah.
And then when you guys went away, there kind of wasn't anything like it for a long time.
Oh, it was giving fabulous work to actresses. And not only that, we had very good women writers on the show as well.
And we now see you approaching the 40th anniversary of the show. You're hosting a cast reunion and a fan event next February.
Yes.
You've got dozens of members of the cast turning up, plus, which is fantastic, some of the crew members.
Yeah, I was so delighted because very often the crew don't get a Guernsey. They get left out. Not our crew, though. They never were left out. And, in fact, on one occasion, we were all invited to the Logies, and they invited the whole cast without partners. I had a partner because I'd been nominated. And I said, no, you can't invite women to a thing like that without partners. And they said, well, that's the way it has to be. And I said, OK, then I'm not going.
No, good on you.
Good on you.
And they went, oh, no, you have to. You know what? I said, I'm not going. If you don't invite them with partners. So they said, oh, all right, Val. And they gave in.
Oh.
And the rest of the women took the crew.
Oh, wow!
As their partners.
What a great story.
That's great. I mean, we can't take Herman to our parties, but that's a court order thing.
No, it's totally different.
But we always regarded the show as a team. Mm. It wasn't just out there, so, the crew and that we were very close.
So tell us a little bit more about this reunion. Can fans come along and mix with the stars of the show?
Well, they can come along, yes, absolutely. It's a champagne high tea. It's being held in Melbourne, and I'm selling tickets to the fans to come. Only about 300 would be allowed to come.
Is it out of jail?
And the money goes to two charities.
Mm. Oh, good one.
What are they, Val?
And the two charities are a very small one in Melbourne called Positive Women, which I think is very apt, that looks after women with HIV and AIDS. And it's also the same charity I used when I was on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. And the other charity, because I am now a wildlife warrior, is Australia Zoo.
Fantastic.
Because well, I actually like animals more than I like most people.
Will there be a laundry press at the event?
I don't so.
Val, the popularity of the show, it was inevitable there was going to be a spin-off or a remake at some point. Wentworth, the modernised version of the show, are you a fan of that? Have you watched that intently?
I started off watching it because they actually gave me the platinum program, so I could watch it. But then, of course, I got work straight away touring in the musical Grease for a year and a half, so I had to actually tape it so I could watch it.
Oh, OK.
And what'd you think?
They got away with a lot of stuff that we weren't even allowed to touch. I had to beg to be allowed to swear. So the first couple of episodes I went, woo! Bit different, but I guess it's perhaps more real too.
Mm. Well, for more information on the event, this big prisoner reunion, and to purchase tickets, you can email pris40th@gmail.com.
Val? Yes, it's capital P.
A capital P, case sensitive.
And lowercase riz, 40, F40th@gmail.com, yeah.
All right, darling.
Simple.
Thank you.
And I will answer those myself.
Oh, hello.
Oh,
fantastic.
Really?
Gonna get this is a very hands-on deal.
Be on the emails. Hey, Val, thank you so much for joining us. And enjoy
my pleasure. Thank you for having me.